to ask about the this other duty of the Supreme Court as the Presidential Electoral Tribunal. Can you give us an update with the head case involving Vice President Robredo? Or baka kahit wag na, basta can we just want to know parang when will it end? Parang can halfway na ng term ni Presidente. So yung uncertainty or certainty is according to both sides.
This is something that I have to share with you. Ano? The Supreme Court is the Presidential Electoral Tribunal. But the Presidential Electoral Tribunal has a separate identity. But this is a very a matter of very high public interest because it involves also, to an extent, the stability of the government, the Philippines. It is foremost in the minds of all the members of the PET to do away with this case, to resolve this case in the earliest possible time. But we have to understand also the needs of this case. We have to be very careful about what to decide here. We are aware that the public is uneasy about our foot dragging. Siguro ang tawag nila dyan, but it is not really foot dragging. If you would know the effort that we have expended in the revision process, ito kasi, this is a combination of a protest as well as a variation of protest. Kung protest kasi, you need to count votes. Under the rules of the PET, there are, on the part of the protestant, precincts or provinces that have been identified, which should be subject of the vote count, of the examination of ballots. And that took time, so we brought in revisors, etc. We appointed three commissioners so that we will be spared the task of going over these ballot boxes, cluster. Very soon, we are expecting that the ponente, who is Justice Yuwa, will come up with his report. And he has informed us that this report will be a very voluminous report. And that is expected because when you have revisited or revised ballots coming from at least three provinces that were part of the protest, you would expect details of whether this ballot, this that ballot, etc., are to be part of the counting or not to be part of the counting. Okay, I know the impatience of the public about this case of the Vice President being protested. But we should also be careful about what we do here because the credibility of our processes as well as of the political system here is at stake. So, tantahan kami, but we are doing it with sufficient speed. It's low in the public's perception, but yung speed namin, kung tutusin mo, ay mabilis. Now, even if there is a perception na nadidelay yan, we are also doing our share from within. We are reminding each other, hindi lang yung ponente, we are reminding each other about the need for results. We do not say that this result should come tomorrow or the next month, etc. It all depends on how we process the protest. Now, there is another kind of protest which involves whether there was massive fraud or not. This does not depend on counting of individual ballots. This will depend on probably a finding that at least a sufficient number of votes were fraudulent or were influenced by terrorism, etc. So that is the next thing that we will probably do. But I'm not going to mention here kung ano na ang progress dyan because I am not yet authorized to divulge any result in that respect. There was one part of it, there were three causes of action and one of them was already dismissed upon the motion of the leader, Bongbong Marcos. So let's all pray. I think I join you there, that we should be concerned really, but we are doing everything according to processes.